Hey, you! Hungry for excitement? Snap into a stampede, my brother!
I don't know what happened to my voice. I sound like I was hoarse or something. I'm Birdman316 here. Have a little bit of fun. Yokozuna, the king of monster trucks, just had to step in there and add a little flavor. But anyway, this is Rattlesnake 2.0. Still looks about the same, but I have the adjustments for the rear toe. Well, the rear toe, I couldn't do anything about that because it's fixed. What do you call those things? Wheel carriers. Axle bearing carriers. Okay. But I do have the camber adjustments correct. I have just a little bit of negative camber on the front so that I can kind of skate across those ruts and whatnot and maybe not get flipped over. And you notice that front bumper. I took it off of the club truck because I really see no reason to have it on the club truck. The club truck is a very slow truck. And one would look at the video and say, man, that fan got enough power to get out of his own way. But that's the point of it being slow. For being a club truck, for new hobbyists looking to get into it. That way, they won't tear up my truck and I won't be fixing the truck every other day or something like that. So there's a point in having it slow like that. I put a normal stock bumper on the front of the club truck. Which it'll serve well. I put a little fiberglass tie bar. Well, this is the rattlesnake truck here, but basically is sort of the same thing as a club truck, built out of the same stuff. Now these shocks right here, these aren't gonna be. I might use these bodies. I have to inspect and make sure they're not leaking. But I ordered some green shock lids. Shock caps to be right there. And I ordered some springs. I'm trying to decide what color I should put on here. Now these back ones, I got a little concerned about these. I'll put the phone right down here where you can see under the chassis. How often do you get to crawl under a monster truck with yours truly, Birdman? Okay, you see where that shock end is? It's right there at the last hole. Which that's where you really want it because you want it to be stable. I don't really want to move it in the next hole right there because I want to raise it up just a tad because when you put your speed control in, your motor and all that stuff, it's going to squat. It's going to just a little bit. You know, it's going to go down a little bit. So it's already squatting now a little bit. It's just barely level, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to probably get some Savage, yep, HPI Savage shock rod ends and put them on these Traxxas shocks here. I'll probably have to use a Savage clips, the bottom clips, and put some soft springs on there with some like 45 weight oil and all four of them, all four shocks getting 45 weight oil. And the front end, you can see it's a little, well, the half the shocks are empty anyway, so I don't know if the lids got blown off and they just put the lids back on without putting oil in them, but I don't know what the case is. So I'm going to take a chance and reuse these shock bodies here and just probably go with, I think purple springs will look good on here with the green shock lids. So that way you get a little taste of Gravedigger. Little taste of the old gray deer. And you got your green A arms. Actually, some of these bolts up in the front of here, these bolts that holds the chassis to the bulkhead, that's from an old grave digger stampede I used to have. Also, this tie bar thing right here came from old grave digger number 2, which was a nitro stampede. This thing here, these parts right here, came from old grave digger number 2. And last but not least, these screws right here. They're in the bumper. And plus the other screws that are right here in the first part of the skid plate, ladder bar, whatever you want to call it. That also came from my old Gravedigger Stampede, which is a Nitro Stampede, which was Gravedigger number 2. But these tie rods here, these two top tie rods, and these back tie rods right here, they're actually from a slash. But these tie rods here are actually old electric Stampede tie rods. And I had to put these tie rod ends, they're Duratrax. I'm thinking of a diesel truck. Duratrax. No, Dobro. I'll get it out in a minute. Well, that chili was so good at Waffle House, I've just got my mind on chili. Can't even think about trucks right now. Dobro rod ends on the front end here. And I was able to do my little trick where I can take that nut off if I want to and just slip this up. But I forgot you could turn that and make adjustments. You make your toe in adjustments and stuff. Ooh. That's a little bit of lag there, like FPV. Oh, okay, I'll behave. Okay. Have I covered everything? Okay. I made my mind up. On the speed control and the motor setup, I'm getting the orange Sky RC Leopard system. And the motor is like a 9-turn. So it might be too crazy for this truck. He's got all metal gears and a transmission, but I got a concern. These wheels are spinning inside this tire, because you can hold the tire still and turn the wheel inside the tire. So I might just have to get those glued. But anyway, that 9-turn motor is going to be wicked. And I might have to turn this puppy down a little bit so it'll be drivable. So if you have it, you can't have it ballistically crazy, because this is I don't even know how much this thing's going to weigh with everything. It may be 5-6 pounds, maybe at the most. So you don't want it too crazy, to where you can't drive it. You want it fast and powerful, mean, but you don't want to have it just so out there you just can't drive it. You want it driving. So this has been an update. Oh, one more thing. For now, I'll be running some old 3300 nickel metals in it with the brushless setup, to where I can learn the brushless setup on a monster truck. I've never drove a brushless setup on a monster truck. Well, maybe old Yokozuna could probably show me a thing or two, since he's a world famous king of RC monster trucks. But anyway, this has been an update on the Rattlesnake 2.0 project. This is Birdman 316. Sayonara.
Budman asked me to ask all of his YouTube friends and hobbyists. I have to have his back because he can't remember a lot. He stuffed his face at Waffle House and didn't invite me. Of course, I went and stuffed my face the other day and didn't invite him. So I guess he made it even for me. Okay, he wanted me to ask everyone for the Rattlesnake 2.0 project, which body would you guys like to see on that monster truck? A 55 Chevy or a 72 Chevy, kind of like Farm Truck, our friend in Oklahoma. So, either body would look good, but we would like some input from the YouTube fans all around the world of monster trucks. Which body should we put on that truck? 55 Chevy or the 72 Chevy pickup? Both of them are made specifically for the Traxxas Stampede, and either one will look fine but we just want your input so we can make up our minds. That's about the hardest thing to do about RC trucks, is figuring out what kind of body and what color to paint it. I like it when Budman lets me have the spotlight sometimes. Alrighty, this is yours truly, Yoko. King Yokozuna, king of RC Monster Truck Freestyle. Take it easy, all of our friends in YouTube land.